Y'all, this phone case is nasty. Hi, Shanna Rowe Jackson here from Caution Arts at Play, and today I am going to be decorating a new phone case. My old phone case, as I showed you just a little bit ago, is pretty gross. And I liked it because it's nice and sparkly and pretty normally, and it could show like the natural color of my phone. However, the edges, I don't know if that's going to focus correctly, but look how that rubber turned yellow. Like, how gross is that? And that's just from being in my pocket and stuff. So I have to get rid of it. And unfortunately, there are not a lot of cute options for my phone. I feel like iPhone has the market cornered when it comes to fun phone cases. And I really, really like OtterBox cases because I usually use my phone. I'm actually using my old phone to film right now, but I usually use my phone to film and stuff. Like, my phone, keeping it protected is very important to me. And so I trust the OtterBox brand. This is not sponsored by them. This just happens to be the case that I usually go with. I tried other cases and they've fallen apart and they haven't been as good. And so I really like this brand. So I bought the black one and I think I am going to just decorate it with some markers. And you've seen me use these markers before. These markers will write on pretty much anything. So I'm hoping that it will stick to this surface really well. It's kind of textured to begin with, so I don't think I'll need to do any gesso or anything on it, but hopefully it will stick really well and a nice fresh coat of varnish will work well as well. I'm way behind on this trend because apparently this was a trend at some point, I'm sure, but this isn't really about a trend for me. I genuinely want a new phone case and I wasn't going to buy another of the same because obviously this gets gross and they didn't really have any other cute options. So here we are. And I should mention these were sent to me by this company for a previous video. However, this video is not sponsored by this company either. I just really like these markers because they write on anything. So let's see what we come up with. Okay, so as you can see here, I started by unpackaging the phone case and then I kind of just checked it out, looked it over a little bit, made sure it was in good condition. And then I decided that I would kind of just wash it off a little bit so that I can make sure the surface was clean and didn't have my fingerprints or any oils from my hand that would interfere from using the markers on the surface. And as I mentioned, it is a textured surface, so I didn't feel the need to do really any more prep than that. These markers are really great at writing on pretty much all surfaces, including glass and plastic and everything else. So I wasn't concerned about priming it. So then I just, once it was dry, decided to go right in with my markers. And I wanted this to be kind of a fun, colorful, summery theme. So I decided that I would go with fruit. And it's not going to be realistic, obviously. I wanted it to be just fun and illustrative and just kind of cartoony. And I started off with some orange slices, as you can see. And it was a little difficult at times to get the opacity that I was looking for, obviously, because I'm working on a black case. But it really only took like two coats on some of these colors, and some of them actually really took just like one coat, but most of them took maybe 2 to 3 coats, which really was not that bad. These are pretty opaque markers. And the white is one of the ones that I had to go over numerous times. Part of that is the nib itself. I've used that one a lot, and so it kind of was a little bit dried up. I had to reprime it, and I had to kind of get things flowing again in order for the white to be as opaque as I would have liked. Just back and forth with my little fruit. My main challenge here is going to be finding a way to varnish this, because obviously this is going to be going in and out of my pocket. It's going to be laying on numerous types of surfaces, and so I don't want it to scratch off. This is really durable. These markers are a very durable medium, and for things like glass and, you know, more non-melty things, you can actually bake it in the oven, but obviously this is plastic and rubber, so I'm definitely not going to attempt that today. I don't need a phone case puddle in my oven. And so I want to find a way. I think I'm going to use some matte spray first, and then I may come over it with an acrylic
matte medium or something like that to try and make sure it's nice and sealed so I can wash it off easily and so things aren't going to scrape when they rub up against surfaces. But I'm going to have to think about that a little bit more before I do it. And I'm going to let things cure overnight at least, if not longer. I do have some rain in the forecast coming in my area, and so it might be a little longer before I actually get to varnish it. Because if I'm going to spray it, I'm going to do it outside. So I'll let you know how that goes at the end of the video when I do my reveal once it's on the phone. And so I noticed I tried to do a strawberry with just the red marker, and I noticed that one was a little bit more transparent than my other colors. So I decided to come in with the white to kind of make it more opaque so that I could come over it. Plus it brightened up the color of the strawberries a little bit more. So much fun. I love these markers so much. And I don't know how light fast these are. These aren't markers that I use in my work that I plan to sell. They're definitely more of a craft thing that I use them quite often, but it's not typically on like my fine art. You know, maybe a craft that I would sell, I just not necessarily fine art. Not that I sell my crafts very often. But I don't put it in with, like, my acrylics or anything like that. I have acrylic markers that I have light-fast ratings on that I use in my art if I ever need to use acrylic markers for anything. This was so much fun. And these markers did go down really well. I do wish that I had finer nibs for some of them. The finer details were difficult to get. And so you'll see me struggling here with the cherry stems a lot, especially the cherry leaves. you'll see me come back and forth. And this is really easy to correct as well. These markers wash off pretty easily with alcohol, especially when the markers haven't cured and haven't dried for very long. And so you'll see me come back in sometimes with either a damp paper towel, which is actually soaked in alcohol, or a Q-tip. Like here, I hated that strawberry, so I just took some rubbing alcohol and wiped it out. And there are some parts where it kind of left some residue behind, and you'll see later on I come through with a different black marker, and I kind of fix that a little bit, so you can't really see those, like, those lighter smears on the black background. There I am with a Q-tip. And really, the only reason why there was residue that stayed like that is because of the slight texture of this phone case. This is so much fun. So I used some colors from my 12 set, which is the set that they sent me, but I also bought myself a larger set after I had tried this 12 set because I like them so much. And I had to pull a couple of colors from that set as well that I didn't have in my 12 set, mainly like a light green. And I don't remember what the other color was. There was a couple anyway. I'm just coming through with some highlights. This is definitely not my regular style. It's a little bit bold and obviously not very realistic, but I just wanted just something fun that made me happy to look at. Just very illustrative. And I struggled a lot to get, like, the seeds and some of the finer details, as you can see with that watermelon. And then one of the pens, I had kind of over-primed it, and so it leaked a little. And I'm just fixing that here. But then I come in with, I feel like it's a Molotow marker. And I use that for some of the details, and that's also what I use to correct some of the, like, outer edges, just to clean things up a little bit. Initially, I wanted to do a white outline around all of the fruit. That's kind of how I had envisioned it, kind of make it look like there were stickers all over it, and I would have loved that, but I had such a hard time with my white marker getting opaque, and I didn't want to risk messing it up and it not working the way I wanted, so I opted not to do that. I don't know if this company of markers sells anything that's like a finer line For the most part, I've never really had an issue with detail, but I think this is like the smallest. Well, no, I can't say that. This isn't the smallest that I've worked, but it's just a little bit more difficult to get detail. Yeah, so it is a one for all marker by Molito that I used, and that one has a bit of a finer nib on it for details. Again, I'm not sponsored by any of the companies mentioned. This is what I had on hand that I thought would do the job. I love it. It's just so fun. And it's springtime, obviously, but it's been kind of dreary where I'm at lately. A lot of rain, a lot of wind, and just kind of cloudy days. And so I'm really looking forward to like actual springtime and summertime. And this is just such a fun summer theme. It makes me want to have some juice or some fruit punch or something. And maybe some sort of mocktail. Just something refreshing. And these are some of my favorite fruits to draw, even when I do realism. So I had a lot of fun, like, incorporating that. I thought about doing blueberries. Blueberries would have been fun, too, because I don't have any blue in this. But I didn't end up going with it. I wanted to make sure I had ample, like, room for each of them and that the placement was pleasing. Had to, like, even though I'm working on a different sort of support this time, I still had to think about composition. And I do think some blueberries would have fit in well in between, but I didn't want it to be too crowded either, because I just wanted to kind of have some fun dots at the end too, to fill some of those spaces. Just kind of a fun little cascade of fruit. Also, this is like one of the first things I've done since I've been cleared. I should mention, for those of you who watched my previous video, I spoke about how I had been injured at my day job, and I just recently got cleared by employee health, so I'm not on light duty anymore, and I am allowed to draw and paint again. So this is the first project I've done with my left hand. So I didn't want to get too crazy with it or too detailed. I just wanted to have fun and be a little bit more lighthearted about it. Nothing too strenuous.
So this is what I have so far. I really, really like it. I had to redo this strawberry a million times and it's kind of annoying, but that's okay. I like it so much so far. I am going to kind of let it cure overnight, just like let it dry really, really well before I come back to varnish it. And I'll come back with fresh eyes tomorrow, see if I need to make any adjustments. And then if I do make adjustments, then I'll let it dry overnight again, just to be sure. And then I'm going to varnish the heck out of it and pray that the varnish will be enough to keep it protected. These are pretty sturdy and durable, but alcohol cleans them up really well. And so I just want to be sure that I varnish it enough so that things won't make it lift or scratch off or anything. But for the time being, I'm going to let it dry really well. And then I will come back tomorrow and I will film and show you some updates. Okay, so here it is. I think it looks so cute on the phone. I'm really excited about how it looks. We did coat it with a protective finish. The first thing that I did was I put a matte acrylic spray over it, but I wasn't really happy with how that came out because it actually left like a white residue. I have to get rid of that spray because I'm not pleased at all with how that came out. However, I did that as an isolation coat so that I could put something stronger over it. And my husband came up with the idea of using polyurethane because that's a really, really strong kind of coating. And so that's what we ended up doing. We ended up dipping it, but it had a weird effect on the parts that I drew. If you look at this piece of watermelon, you can see it kind of made it like goopy looking on the sides, and it made them all kind of rise up a little. And so I'm not exactly sure how that's going to work when I'm using it all the time. Like, I don't know if them being lumped out is going to make it so they get scraped off or anything like that. And that's kind of the whole reason why we put a protective coating on it to begin with, was in hopes that this wouldn't scrape off. So only time will tell. This was a big experiment for me. Clearly, I do not draw or paint on plastic very often. So we'll just see. I just kind of jumped into it and time will tell. We'll see how it wears out, but I will use this until it does. I think I am going to let it cure a little bit more before I use it all the time because it kind of has a bit of a scent to it still, and I don't want to be touching it all the time. I think it still needs to cure a little bit more. So I am going to put my old case on for a little bit, but I'm going to let it cure, and then I can show it off to people. All right, so thank you so much for watching. I had a lot of fun with this. It was a fun experience, and I have a few other things coming up on the channel. I will be doing a review soon of the Faber-Castell Pitt Graphite Matte Pencils. I've had them for a while, and I've been meaning to review them for a while, but I've had a lot going on. And I also have another Art Snacks box that I am going to be opening on the channel. And that one has a little bit of a twist, so I'm really excited about that as well. So if that's something that interests you, feel free to subscribe if you haven't already. Also, if you've watched this far, please comment below with your favorite fruit, and I will see you next week. You have a great day. Bye.